Okay, so now we are going to see about inheritance and the type of inheritance. So what is normally an inheritance? So inheritance, we have seen something called classes, and what we can do is we can provide a relationship between the classes, and this kind of relationship we can put with the help of this inheritance. For example, when you take when you assume a class called animal, and when you take like another class called dog, we can put a relationship between two classes, like dog is an animal, dog is an animal, or you can put something like house as a building, like that. So this dog is considered to be the base class, or the sorry, the dog is considered to be the subclass, and animal is considered to be the base class. It's nothing but like this animal is a parent class, and this dog is a child class. Okay. So this is one example. Then you can put another thing like cricket is a sport. So cricket is a parent class, and sorry, sport is a parent class, and cricket is a child class. So in other term, this child class is otherwise called as derived class, and this parent class is otherwise called as base class. Okay. So can you just give me some more example about this? So I have given two example. Can you just type some more example about this kind of relationship? I have given dog is an animal, cricket is a sport. Can you just put some of your examples of inheritance so that we'll discuss? Just put it in your chat. So just give some example of inheritance. Yeah. So another one example is circle is a shape. Then circle is a shape. Then parrot is a bird. Then car is a vehicle, like that. So that kind of example we can put for inheritance. That means we have two class, namely like base class and subclass or derived class. We will provide a relationship between these two classes with the help of inheritance. So what we are going to do is we are going to write a program to do that. Okay. So what we'll do is we'll take a classical example, like a animal which we have given in in the assignment. Okay. So first let me create a folder. I have already created a folder called week 2. So I will create a notepad, and I will create something called animal. Then I will create something called dog. Then I will create something called main. So this main is nothing but it represents the main class, and this animal and dog is considered to be a separate class. So we can have public static void main string args. Okay, so like that we'll do. So what we have did is we have created three class, namely like class animal, then class dog, then class main dem. So what we are going to do is we are going to provide some relationship between this class dog and this class animal. So this kind of relation can be done with the help of inheritance. And we are going to see there are different types of inheritance. One is single, then second one is multiple, multi-level, hierarchical, and hybrid, and so on. So the thing is we have only single and multi-level and hierarchical in Java, because multiple inheritance will not be supported. So we will see every example one by one. So let me start with a single inheritance. So single inheritance is nothing but it will have only one base class, say animal, and it will have only one derived class, and we will provide some extension, like we will provide some we can extend as class with another class like that. So let me put an example. So we are going to have something called animal as a base class and dog as a derived class. So what we'll do is we'll provide some relationship between that. Okay. So this is said to be animal and this is said to be dog. So we have a single base class and single derived class, and we are providing a relationship between these two classes, and that is said to be a single inheritance. We have single base class as well as single derived class, and the arrow should be from base class to derived class. Okay, or I think yeah, I've given wrong thing. So it's like opposite way. It should not be like this way. So it should be like this way. So the first one is base class animal, and the second one is derived class dog. So the arrow should be from dog to animal, because the dog is going to get all the properties of animal. So it will be like from arrow from dog to animal. So the what I have said earlier is wrong. So this is the correct one. So we'll write a program for it. Already I have created class called animal and class called dog. We are going to have some methods. So first I'm going to create a relationship between animal and dog. So here, which is the base class? The base class is animal, and which is the derived class? Derived class is the dog. So the dog is going to extend all the properties of the base class animal. So I can use something called extends keyword. So extends animal. That means dog is the subclass of animal. So what I can do is I can create some method like public void get name like that. So I can put something like system.out.println. Name of the animal. So you can pass the name also. For example, I can pass string name. So the name of the animal is plus name I can give. So here also I can put something like public void get breed. So I can put string breed name. So I can put something like so breed name. So breed name of the dog is breed name. Now we have two methods like get name in animal, and we have something called get breed in dog. And since dog is a derived class, since we are using the keyword like extends animal, what will happen is the method that is associated with animal will be comes under dog now, so that we can create only like we can have only dog object, so that we can call all the methods like get name and get breed like that. So that is the advantage of inheritance. So normally when there is no inheritance, we have to create a object for animal, then we have to create object for dog like that. But when you extend dog with animal, so all the methods that is associated with animal now will comes under the class called dog. So now we can have only so we can create only object for object for derived class alone. Because the dog is extending all the properties of animal. So there is no need for creating an object for animal and the object for dog. So I can create only the object for dog. So dog D equal to new dog. Then we can put something like dog dot, sorry, D dot get name. So I will specify here, I will specify the name of the dog, sorry, name of the animal. So I will put dog. Then I will put D dot in get breed, I can put the breed name. So say it is like puppy. So now what will happen, what I have created is I have created the object for the derived class alone. Since this derived class is already extending the base class animal, so I can have like only one object called a derived class object, which can take all the properties of the base class because we are using the keyword extends. Okay, so now let me save this. We have three class like animal, dog, and main demo. So what I can do is I can save this file name as main-demo.java because it has the public static void main. So I will save this main-demo.java. So now I will compile this. So I'll go to desktop. So I will copy this and I'll go to command prompt. Then Java C. Main demo.java. To compile that, I have used Java C main demo.java. To run that, I have to use Java space main demo. Okay, when I press enter, what you can see is you can see the name of the animal dog and the breed name of the dog is puppy, like that. So this is called as inheritance. You can see like three classes have been generated: animal.class, dog.class, and main demo.class. So this is the concept of inheritance. Like this is the concept of single inheritance, where we can have a single base class and we can have a single derived class. This single derived class extends all the properties of the base class. So we can have like only the object for the derived class. Using the object for the derived class, we can inherit all the properties of the animal as well as the dog. So this is all about single inheritance. And like, if you have any doubt, you can ask me now in the chat. So any doubt on single inheritance? So that we'll discuss and we'll go for the next one. Okay, so I will again revise this. So we have like three classes: animal, dog, and main demo. Inheritance is nothing but to create a relationship between the classes. We can go for inheritance. We have three classes like animal, then dog, and main demo, like that. So what I have created is I have created three classes like animal, dog, main demo, and I'm going to consider animal as the base class and dog as the derived class. So I will write the method for animal and I will write the method for dog. So since the dog is the derived class, I will provide a keyword extends so that it will extend all the properties of the base class. So the syntax is like class name of the derived class extends the base class name. So the base class name is animal. So if we do that, all the properties of animal now comes under the dog. Now we can have like only we can create only object for the dog, so that we can get all the properties and methods associated with that inheritance. Any doubt? So like get breed means in my program, the question is what represents the breed name, like breed name, like so dog is the category of animal, breed name is like category of the dog, for example puppy. Then we have some different names, like different breed names, like for example It's like a different breed name. Puppy is one breed name. Then we have different breed names. Okay, so any doubt in this, we'll go for the next inheritance. Or if you have any doubt, maybe we'll have some discussions.